This is a very special instrument fabricated and designed for explaining the phenomenon of angle of minimum deviation using a prism. The device is consisting of a laser pointer. If I make this on, you can get a line here, and a zero reading is observed here. It is straight line. Now I insert this prism in this slot. It is push fit, and now I switch on the laser. You can see the ray going like this, and like this. So we have the change of direction. It is called as deviation. And the angle of deviation here can be measured directly on the circular scale. It is very simple modification of the spectrometer-like instrument. And I given name vertical spectrometer because in lab, the spectrometer is horizontal. There is source of light. There is one collimator. There is one prism table. There is one telescope. And only one eye can observe at a time. But here, we can observe this phenomenon in a very simple way. You can observe that ray of light is coming here. It is incident here. It is getting change of medium from air to glass. So it bends towards the normal. Now, when it comes from glass to air, it bends away from normal. So the bending is twice, once inside and once outside. But because of this triangular prism, these two bendings are added up, and overall we get a large deviation. This large angle of deviation is coming because we are having a triangular prism. Here it is isosceles triangle, angle of prism is 60 degree, and we can observe one interesting phenomenon here, that if I turn the prism either in the anticlockwise or in the clockwise direction, I observe that this ray comes up and again goes down. You can see here. Now I'm turning anticlockwise. When I turn anticlockwise, it comes up and goes down. Now I turn clockwise. When I turn clockwise, it again comes up and goes down. Now, one may ask the question, why this happens? Why it comes up and why it goes down? That is exactly minimum deviation. Why? This angle is, say, initially 60, 70, then it becomes 50, then it becomes 40. So it has decreased. When angle decreases, and then I continue to rotate further, it increases. So the U-shaped graph is observed for the angle of deviation when you are plotting the graph against the angle of incidence. So here, angle of incidence can be changed by turning the prism, and we can observe this beam coming up and down, and that is indication of minimum deviation. And if I know, if I can measure directly angle of minimum deviation, I can calculate the mu, that is refractive index of the prism. Refractive index mu is given by a very simple formula. Mu is equal to sine of a plus delta m divided by 2, and in denominator, sine of a by 2. So this is a simple way of finding mu of prism. Now, if I change the prism with some high quality, high mu prism, I may get angle of deviation different, more. More density, more dense prism, more index, I'll get more angle of deviation. Minimum deviation will be more. Second thing, if I change the color of this laser, say instead of green, I use red laser or blue laser, I'll get delta M different because the glass has different mu for different colors, for different wavelength frequencies. And that also can be verified by using different color lasers. One more thing. Today, we have no white laser, but in future, suppose somebody makes a very powerful beam of light, white light, and we pass this white light here, we can see the separation of colors here. It is the property of the glass, dispersion, and we can have separation of wavelengths, and that is why the rainbow is seen in the sky when it is raining in sunlight, because the color separation is property of the transparent medium. Here, we can say that this apparatus is very useful to explain the concept, phenomenon of angle of minimum deviation of prism. And this is my own design, idea, fabrication, assembly, carpentry, everything. So thank you.